This will be a quick video on LTX-2 video models, running on my 4060 Ti 16GB card. You can try if you are running a 12GB GPU with 64GB of system RAM. I think it may work. The workflow in front of us is for Stable Video Infinity. I made a simple video with workflow just now, and then LTX released their models. So before we begin, update comfyUI using this update batch file in the update folder. Restart comfyUI, and then inside templates. There are so many new options added here. And here are the new workflows, text to video and image to video. Depth to video and canny to video are basically video to video generation. At the end, there is this distilled workflow, which should be giving us results in 8 steps. My recording stopped here for some reason. I clicked this image-to-image workflow and this text-to-video for distilled models. So I kept assuming it was recording, but nothing happened. All I did was make mistakes and saw errors in comfyUI. The result you see here is a bad result. Right now, the task in progress is taking 8 seconds for one step. And there are 20 steps, which means this is not a distilled workflow. This is the image-to-video workflow we saw in the template section of comfyUI. And note that I am generating 720-pixel video at a very decent speed. The reason this looks fast is because the progress bar you saw here was working on a low-resolution video, despite the given resolution of 720-pixel. I haven't looked inside how it works, but I'm sure this is generating a low-resolution video and then upscaling the same to 720 pixels. This is something similar to games where the game is rendered at a low resolution and then upscaled to make the video game run on a bigger screen. So it took 365 seconds to generate a video, but this was the first run after a restart. So I will try again.
Welcome to Rosie's. What can I get for you today? Welcome to Rosie's. What can I get for you today?
The subject looks good to me. This was the first decent result generated. I will quickly try again to see how it goes. I will upload an image and run the workflow. I canceled because I forgot to change the aspect ratio. So I have changed the resolution and ran the workflow. The second run took 242 seconds to generate an output. The difference was around 120 seconds after the first run. So this was a mistake from my side. I didn't pay attention towards the prompt. The prompt was about a restaurant. The given image was neglected, and the model followed the prompt.
Welcome to Rosie's. What can I get for you today? Welcome to Rosie's. What can I get for you today?
The result looks good. A point here we should note is the woman here matches the image we tried before. I think we need to change the prompt every time to get a different character. Let's look at the files I am using to make this work locally. First is the checkpoint, and I have downloaded 3 checkpoints, out of which the first and third did not work. I wanted this FP4 to work, because of the smaller file size of 16GB. This distilled file did not give any error, but the result was bad. When using a distilled model, we can get the result in 8 steps by keeping the CFG value at 1, which I tried, and this is the result. I will try again after making this video. The file is 25GB in size, which is similar to the normal FP8 checkpoint. I also searched for GGUF files, and this is the only one I found with a file size of 15GB. Also, the repository says this is for testing, so I'm not sure whether more files will be uploaded or not. I will get the file and save it inside the UNET folder. I will try and see if it works. I just thought of checking Kajai's repository, and he had uploaded VAE an hour ago. So I am expecting GGUF and text encoder files, which will replace the checkpoint with GGUF workflow. Next is this text encoder, and note that this text encoder does not work with this checkpoint. I have not gone through with all the details, but this text encoder could be for audio, because the checkpoint above should contain a text encoder as well. We should get the text encoder once the GGUF models are released. As per my understanding, we will be using two text encoders in the GGUF workflow. The text encoder given here is larger in size. So I have downloaded a smaller FP8 version of the same. This is the file. And there are a few new files uploaded in this repository. I have added the link to the GGUF test file we saw on Hugging Face, and also the FP8 text encoder, which I am using right now. Next is the LoRa, and both the files are downloaded here. Then there is this upscale model, which goes in this latent upscale models folder. Note that this is not the normal upscale model we normally use to upscale images and video in pixel format. This is upscaling the video inside the K-sampler itself. As said before, the video generation was fast because it was being generated in smaller resolution and then upscaled in the sampler itself. Place the file here. Now select the file in this workflow. This node here was connected like this, but there is a problem. For some reason, the node does not read all the files present in the folder. I have three files and only one file was visible here. And yes, I am aware about pressing the letter R to reload the file list. Remove the connections and select the FP8 file. And here you should be selecting the text encoder. When using the distilled model, I changed the CFG here. The value was 1 and the step was 8. But it failed. Select the LoRa file here. This is the LoRa file selected here. And below is the upscale model for latent upscaling. There are settings for FPS and video length, which I have not covered. I still need to test before recommending. So that was all with the files. And an important thing you may need to do is open your comfyUI folder. This file, the NVIDIA GPU batch file, edit this file in a notepad. You should be seeing only this part, and this was added by me. At the end, the word pause got selected by mistake. I added a space and then these flags, or you can also say it extra parameters. After making these changes, save the file and restart comfyUI. So I have given the parameter here, you can copy it. There is this one more workflow I tried. It takes an audio file and an image, but then I was using the distilled model. I will make a separate video for this. Now let's look at the text to video workflow. This FP4 did not work, so I will use the FP8 file. As this is a distilled workflow, I will use the distilled checkpoint. I will try the settings the same as before, at 720 pixels, and run the workflow. It took 185 seconds, and I got a bad result. I just checked inside the subgraph, and the file name here was FP4. I do not know about this missing connections. I selected the distilled FP8 checkpoint. The upscaler and text encoder looks correct. So I queued the workflow. The video generation is in progress, and after 288 seconds, I got the result. The result generated is a full HD video.
La tona è mobile. La tona è mobile.
I can finally say that I am generating full HD videos on my 4060 Ti 16GB. Make sure you check inside after selecting over the graph. This VAE is connected, but I don't remember removing this connections. Also remember to remove the extra parameters added in the batch file. So that is it in this video. I hope this was helpful and have an excellent day.